him.
All right. Here we go. Hype finals.
We got something for you. So, these guys, having just seen each other in winners, I'm actually going to go over here and do this quickly. Nailed it. Just seen each other in winners finals. Triple R pulling out a clutch game 5 win. This could be very, very intense. We could see something very, very exciting here, especially since Swag is gathering all that momentum from what he just did against Pow Pow.
Yes. Oh, the way he ended that last game.
There's nothing better than a set ending with a reset. But we'll see. And both these characters have reset capabilities. Randall's, or Triple R, is famous for it in Melee. We'll see if it happens here. Otherwise, Smashville for game 1. This is an easy agree. I'm sure both of them are like, Smashville? Okay, fine.
Oh, gets down there early.
Of course. Yep, on any other character except maybe Sonic and Mega Man, that would look just fine. But little spring recovery. Sorry about it.
Yeah.
So something that Triple R has said time and time again about Mega Man, and especially Swag's Mega Man, is that it's really hard for him, despite being a very large lemon himself, he can't deal with the smaller lemons. He has a really hard time recomposing himself after getting barraged by jab and neutral air and all the variants of the lemons, all of which are the same, of course. But
yes, Swag is definitely like a lemon master. Wow. He's an artist with those things.
Both these characters, of course, and these players having phenomenal ledge games. We just saw Triple R and Swag there, kind of having more fight off the stage than on. I think we'll see a lot of that in these sets.
Yeah.
We'll see a lot of retreating to middle. Wow. Hard knuckle hitting just right there.
Yeah, that and Triple R both go off stage, kill you. It's so annoying trying to come back against them.
And I'm sure they'll know each other over the next...
Oh, of course, Mega Man, fine.
Again!
Rush's clutch.
Something that Swag will have to learn really quickly if Randall's going to, or if Triple R's going to go for more of those, is to DI always in to get the stage. Mm-hmm. That's something that he didn't do right there, but luckily he had the FB.
Yep.
Triple R starting to incorporate up Bs in his playstyle way more frequently than he used to. He's learned that, I think, a bit from Prince Kirby, who uses up Bs quite a bit, especially to punish things and try and spike.
Yeah.
Ooh. Oh, and the trump! Frames, I think it's what, 5,
yeah,
8,
five?
And 11.
Oh,
the three hits. Ooh, yeah, it's frame 5. Wow.
Randall takes it right back very.
I did not expect that reset that fast. I expected Swag to go into heavy defense mode, but he hung out on the Smashville platform left hand side.
And Randall took advantage.
What's interesting, you just saw there, I didn't realize that Rush could half spawn. Randall up aired or up tilted as Mega Man was up being, and Rush half spawned and then disappeared.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he was around for maybe 3 or maybe 4 or 5 frames.
Yeah. Rush is a good get out of trouble option.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
I can say, talking to Triple R before this match, he was really, really pulling for Swag. I think he feels way more confident in the anti-Mega Man matchup than he does against Sonic.
Yeah, I know he hates chasing Sonic down. That's like one of his pet peeves. I hate having to run after this character.
Mm-hmm. And especially since he hasn't had to deal with a Sonic since Spinner in the summertime, he's sort of had a lack of practice. But with Swag, at least, Swag's been a constant presence, and it's been very easy for Triple R to sort of learn about this matchup. As we see there, ducking under the pellets.
Yeah, Kirby's duck so good.
He can duck under.
Is that
going to be a... Wow, and there was a footstool right at the end. A gorgeous way to end that stock for Triple R. But Kirby can duck under pellets. He can duck under neutral B when not grabbed. If Mega Man drops the neutral B and throws it, Kirby will get hit when he's crouching, but if he just neutral Bs forward, Kirby can crouch it.
Alright.
It's a really weird, gimmicky thing. Ooh, sure, you can wake up short. Well, wake up short, you literally.
It's a sweet spot, so.
Nope.
Randall's gonna be fine. Despite being one of the lightest characters in the game.
Ooh,
Randall goes for the inhale. Doesn't work out, but he didn't get punished, so it's okay. Ooh. Oh, I thought he was going to go off there for another one.
Surprising that Swag was so immediate with that jump to try and jump Nair. That's what got him down air. Had he stayed on the ledge for a little while longer, he would have gotten a really great attempt to punish, even if he just short hop Nair'd again.
Yeah. Ooh. He might have been expecting Randall to try and ledge trump him, so jump beats ledge trump.
That's true. Ooh, going for the spike, not quite getting it because Randall covered in. Yep. Triple R. Whatever.
Triple Randall.
Triple Randall, as his Twitter name is. You can follow him at triple underscore Randall.
Ooh, nice back air. All right, 73-0. Swag.
That Swag.
That is the comeback king. If anyone can make this comeback, it's him.
That was another very Prince Kirby-style thing, down being right as someone was to cover it, that really hard read. Of course, Randall does it, too.
Yeah.
Regardless.
Prince Kirby is more known for his hard reads.
Absolutely. Again, Randall going for the down air as Swag is going to drop an up and jump nair, but doesn't quite get the far away.
Nope.
Swag's really conditioned himself to do very well against Triple R's down airs. He seems to know exactly when to hold shield. He's able to read when Triple R's going to go in for a grab or not. So as you see Randall try and attempt more dares, you'll see Swag trying to pick the option. Oh, the spike!
The comeback! I told you. He's the comeback king.
Wow.
Oh, my God.
Wow, I'm leaning off screen. Don't fully to update stuff, guys. I'm not, you know.
Oh, my God.
Hey.
Swag,
oh
though.
My
he's just
gosh.
Like, he's like, huh. I'm glad that happened.
But that was like spike attempt number 9, just for the record. That was easily spike attempt number 9.
It only takes one, y'all.
You're absolutely right.
It only takes one.
Going to Lilat. This is a stage that Swag chose against Pow Pow and
yeah, he got Lilated.
Yeah, and did not do especially well. So despite that demoralizing moment, it's surprising that we're going back here.
Yeah, I'm surprised he doesn't auto-ban this.
It's interesting because all of Mega Man's projectiles are linear. They all follow a straight line pattern and get interrupted by the curves of the ship. Kirby don't care. Kirby stuff all works still.
Yep.
If anything, up throw gets weirder. Kirby has additional mix-ups that utilize the curve of the ship. But again, this is a wise counter pick for Triple R. I have to wonder what Swag bans.
Yeah, what doesn't he like against Kirby? Like,
it's a very... Who knows?
Because he was telling me he doesn't like Lilat, period, because he was surprised that we banned it and he doesn't like it. Mm-hmm. And I was like, dude, I hate that stage. There's no way I'm playing on it.
Characters have to deal with it where they have linear means of killing. I have a really hard time there.
Yeah.
I used to love it as Rob, but started realizing how much it interrupts my own play. Oh, look at Kirby's little thing, a little
pebble.
It was like a binky, yeah. It was like stuck right over his mouth like a binky. You bet you didn't think you'd hear the word binky tonight on the stream, huh? The hot chat. Press 1 if you're excited about binkies.
Oh, yeah, binky. Binky hype.
Binky. Oh, my gosh.
Yep.
Wow, the bear.
Yep,
ooh, didn't kill, though.
Oh, my God.
The vectoring.
Everyone's Everyone's been vectoring.
That was a really risky up B. Notice that Triple R really took that faith that the ship wasn't going to start fucking really fast. That up B, the ledge wasn't even on screen. He just knew. It's one of those weird things that I don't take those risks. If I were playing Kirby, I would never take those risks. But Triple R does, and that might explain one of the reasons why he's here.
Yeah, practice makes perfect.
Absolutely.
Oh, on his foot.
Not a binky. Lack of binky hype.
Swag just like having so much pressure. Just standing backwards towards Reno, and Reno knows he's like, I can't come anywhere in this area.
Nope. At this point, it's just 20 projectile up in here. Swag doing everything he can to wall Triple R out, to limit his options, and Triple R having to make really risky choices to get in and to really make any damage whatsoever.
Yeah, Lemon definitely putting in work on Triple R right now. The little standoff they had.
Little pause. It's wise for both players. Both players need to be a little more reactive, and I think that Triple R is looking to try and feed Swag's movement a little bit more.
Yeah.
If it's a constant problem he's having with jumps and nairs and the pellets, then what you have to do is you have to figure out when Swag uses them, why he's panicking, and how he moves when he uses them. The minute you encode how a Mega Man moves, wow, that was a really risky up smash, but paid off. The minute you figure out how a Mega Man moves when they're nairing or doing any sort of pellet, you can start taking advantage.
And I think it's only like the third one that will have lag on it. The other two,
right? And of course, annoyingly, the first one has a significant amount of knockback right at the base of the gun. There's a little bit of burst that goes like, "Wow!"
Ooh, beautiful punish.
Oh my gosh, we're at 3 stocks to 1 Mega Man at kill percent, of course. Oh, we got the binky hype. Mega Man could die to literally anything at this point,
but just up smash.
There we go. Yep.
Gets up smashed right as he winds up.
Swag's patented up B then jump. Always throwing people off. Even Randall didn't seem to quite expect it quite a lot.
Up tilt. Oh.
The rush is really functioning very well for Swag as a means to get out of Randall's very, 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 very potent combos.
Yeah, Kirby is definitely one of the better combos in this game. If he has an advantage, that's it.
Wow, a dash attack. It's rare to see dash from Triple R. One of Kirby's attacks with such an extreme amount of punishable lag.
Decent for punishing the lane.
Gets the last hit. Despite the spike, is enough to kill.
Randall this man
trying
back.
Really hard.
Yeah.
He does not want a bracket reset. He does not want that exhaustion to be gone. He is tired. He has had a long day.
Melee.
Yep.
Melee singles.
Getting to loser's finals in melee. Getting winning melee doubles. Wow.
Randall gets a beautiful up smash.
How far did you guys make it in doubles? Fourth?
Fourth.
Fourth. I mean, that's a long day for that, too. And then, I mean, knowing as a TO, Triple R has gone back and forth across this room all day. Do you need me? Can I go here? It's a constant thing at these monthlies, and it's something that really wears a player down. Yep. You can tell everything from his posture right now to the way that he's responding to things, to his punishes are a little more
sloppy.
Well, they're also a little more flowcharty. They're a little more like, oh, this happens, so I'll do that. Yeah. Exactly. Shout out to Thor for being my my Moobot, my automated, like, someone says exclamation point bracket and Thor responds to the bracket. Thank you, Thor.
Ooh. Ooh.
I don't understand these. Okay, I sort of understand these up smashes. Wow. Just a random forward smash. I don't understand these up smashes. That's why I keep going for.
They're paying off, so I don't know. I think they're random too, but
who knows?
Who knows?
We're going to see. Wow.
That's it.
Game two goes to Swag.
Oh.
Wow.
Will we see the reset?
Are we going to see a reset?
Find out next time on Digimon. No.
Ooh, Digimon, though. Yeah. We see Pow Pow in the background. Shout outs to Pow Pow. Shout outs to the two Wisconsinites we had out here, Plague 2 and Pow Pow, possibly hitting third at his second UMN monthly. Texting away.
Yeah.
Oop, that's the doubles one. That's not the right overlay. All right, here we go.
All right, Battlefield. Big Battlefield.
Oh, okay. Oh, I had a moment where I was like, whoa, wait a damn minute. I wrote the rules list for this event, and I know.
They gentlemen.
You can gentlemen's. That's okay. You can gentlemen's all you want. Oh my god. That's one thing. I've only ever been in the grand finals with Randall once, but I've definitely always try. I will always try and do game one on a dumb stage. We did gamer at St. Cloud.
Oh.
SDC. I lost. But it's fine. Anyway, game three starting off, as every other game has, Swag trying to assert stage control and Randall getting and trying to poke weaknesses in Swag's defenses. Go to flat zone. Shout out to Scooby. Swag zone's a terrible stage.
Oh,
I like
the
mega. Whoa!
Here.
And there's no invincibility. Right, gets better. A good down smash.
Yep. Goes for the percentage.
There's a lot to be said about Triple R's ability to punish people on the ledge. There's a lot to be said about Randall's ledge pressure. Which I just said. And it's something that. Whoa!
Oh, Battlefield.
Got,
yeah,
battlefielded.
They changed that.
He got lilated on Battlefield.
I hate that.
That's a phenomenal piece of momentum for Triple R, though, to take advantage of that. And now to have a half stock. I mean, he's 50%, so he can die fairly soon. But just to take advantage of that and try and get as much as he can, unless he dies to a tornado.
Which can happen if he dies just up.
Wow, what a really, really hungry Shoryuken that was. Just jumping up and saying, nah, I'm going to hit you.
Yeah. Swag trying to, like, punish all of Randall's landings. Like... These up smashes, the up tilts.
Getting a lot of really great reads from Triple R all of a sudden. Really seems to be either tuning into what Swag's patterns are, or even just maybe Swag starting to autopilot himself.
I like how he threw out that up air and punished.
Oh, wow! Wow, wow, wow!
That's been happening to Swag all day.
Oh my gosh! So now Triple R. Oh, okay.
You never mind. Nah.
Still.
it's still an entire stock ahead. Yep.
On game three of what looked like a really dire set for him, he's either woken up or he's really just tapped back in and said, no, I cannot let it go to a bracket reset this easily. I have to put up a fight. Tire Swag out.
Is that cheap? No.
There's plenty of... Triple R has plenty of tournament experience.
Nice tech.
Another great tech. But Triple R has plenty of tournament experience to know that this sort of thing can wear players down. Having been Swag has been just doing things now way more than Triple R has, at least in this game.
Yeah.
And there's just a way of when you like take a piece of wood and you like whittle it away yep. at his patience and capacity to respond. At some point, a flowchart Mega Man gets very easy to read.
Oh,
it's so cute! Oh my god, it's so cute! He got a little helmet. Okay. What's interesting
Kirby
is this actually doesn't help outside of having a projectile. This doesn't really help Kirby that much.
But he's going to get
I think, wow, or not.
See, the helmet's all he needed.
The helmet.
He
it made that forward smash stronger.
He also had 69 guys, shoutouts. Even though Josh hates it.
Oh, whatever. The problem with that is that we can make up a thing for every single number. 64 as a thing, 69 as a thing, 101 as a thing.
Yeah, but 69 is the original.
Yeah, that's true. There is something to be said on pushing there a little bit, so you're going to be in the frame a little bit. Definitely something to be said for originality. All right, game four. Set one of Grand Finals FD.
Best stage.
Something that I feel like, I mean, one of the things that really interests me about Triple R's play and about his philosophy as a player is that he always goes for stages that really pit player v player. There's very little, he very rarely will go to a stage that he considers at all cheapening of the 1v1 experience. When we had stages like Delfino and Halberd and Woohoo for a bit legal, he would vehemently be in this stage and hate having to go there because he felt like the stage became a character on the screen. And so FD, in other games of the series, considered to be one of those stages that really did not assert itself really strongly. In this game, sometimes relegated to a counter pick, but still one of those stages that doesn't assert itself in a way this has done.
Yeah, like, I know FD always gets, like, talked about because of the flash. I've never had FD flash problems, but I hear about them all the time.
Well, in this matchup especially, projectiles tend to disappear in the flash. It makes it hard to see them. Rob's Gyro does this famously. Mega Man's Neutral B will do this. To a good extent, Side B will do it as well. When a flash happens, it's bright enough and it shrinks edges enough where those projectiles kind of disappear briefly. And it gets kind of tricksy. So we'll see if that comes into play here.
Ooh, Swag saw that coming.
Oh, yeah, and there's the good show you can to finish that off. A surprising amount of offense right now from Swag.
I kind of feel like Rando is playing a little bit more like Prince Kirby. I see it now, because that forward air.
It was hungry. And I think that there's, talking to Prince Kirby earlier, there's a lot of the stuff that they gather from each other. I think they've begun studying each other a little more than they did before, just because they realize there are pieces of each other's styles that are optimal.
Yeah.
Prince Kirby has a phenomenal punish game. Not that Randall doesn't. Wow, that was one.
That was
a Prince Kirby read from here to Taiwan. That was a Prince Kirby read.
Randall, he's in his inner prince.
But, like, here's where it is that was a phenomenal read. Had it paid off, it would have been
a stock. Yeah, for sure.
It's something more than Randall usually does. He's usually a little safer, tries pressure offstage, and a lot of Randall's kills come from offstage pressure.
Yeah.
Not definitely just one of kicking your godforsaken head across the stage. Yeah.
Not just, you're going to roll this way. Get out of here.
Shout out to Cheeky in the chat. Thanks for coming out today, Cheeky. Sorry you couldn't play singles. Wow, he learned how to jump. Didn't even up B.
That was
rare. Really weird. You can sort of see it in Randall's face that's a disgruntling. This might be it. This might be the key to the reset. Oh my gosh.
Do you get to take time in between the sets, or do you have
absolutely
to go right back in?
You know, if you want to take a minute, you take a minute. Right. We're not cruel. We're not cruel over here at the UMN Smash. Ooh, the planets whoosh by. God, I love that effect. So stupid.
Oh, nice grab though.
Yeah, it was a phenomenal grab. Triple R has a whole lot of work to do here though.
Yep.
Mega Man does not die readily.
Ooh.
Why did I say things out loud?
It's the blessing, man.
It's the blessing. But again, I mean, Mega Man doesn't die very readily. He is one of the heavier, I think he's in the top 12 heaviest characters, maybe number 11 or 12.
It's
hard. He's made of metal. What do you want?
He doesn't get comboed, really. He's heavy.
Doesn't combo easily. Takes 30 damage from a combo.
Ooh!
Oh, the footstool!
Oh!
Wow, the wall jump! Girl!
The answers.
Oh, God. That was just a whole lot of awareness from Swag saying, I have plenty of options, you don't even know. I thought he got the footstool in.
I thought he did.
I thought it took away a second jump, but maybe something about his up B restores a second jump since he hadn't used it
yet. Well, it doesn't take away your jump.
Oh, it doesn't. Okay. I'm just so used to maybe double jumping in response or something. Who knows, but.
I only know that because I get footstools with Fox a lot with my forward airs.
There you go. Oh, that's true.
And then if they stay calm.
That would have been a phenomenal stock to take for Triple R, but unfortunately. Mega Man, for him. Mega Man can just bounce right back. Literally.
Yep. He's like, don't worry, bro. I'm Mega Man. I'm fine.
Oh gosh, I saw it coming from a mile away. But he doesn't
but
die.
But he's living.
We don't
Rando
die from that.
With the beautiful Vector.
We don't die. We DI. Vector, whatever. We need a good one. We don't expire. We Vector. That was good. Oh, my God. I'm going to try. I'm really looking forward to some post-tournament Perkins. I am. It's been a long day for us here at the TO desk as well. Wow, great up smash. Not going to kill Mega Man again. Heavy, made of metal.
See, I had no plans to go to Perkins, but now I'm
now
like, I'm like, you know what? I've been here long enough.
Wow! He gets the last gust, and it just says...
Well, Kirby is a balloon, so...
All right, I'm going.
That's
I'm
to be expected.
Updates over here. Oh, my gosh, we have a bracket reset.
We got the reset.
Madeers.
Is Randall going to take time?
He's allowed, and if he does, we will respect that.
Swag is like, all right, I got one down. Time to win this tournament. Randall's like, all right.
All right. Set two.
Oh, scratching his head.
Starting right off. Here we go. We didn't get a glasses push, for the record. Plenty of
a head scratch.
No, yep, nothing. Here we go.
No one's gone Super Saiyan yet, guys.
Game one of the bracket reset.
Up this is
the
here first, comes Rush.
This
no
is not
Rush?
The first time that Swag has been in Grand Finals and has had a reset.
Yeah, he gets a lot of seconds.
But will he close it out today? Swag has never won a tournament in Minnesota or otherwise for Smash 4. It has never happened. Despite currently being the statistical number one in the state, he has never finished in first place this day of the day. Randall having a phenomenal day today, having beaten Prince Piano the Beast for the first time in about 3 or 4 months. Is this Randall's day? Whose day is it? We'll find out now. Find out next on Yu-Gi-Oh!
Yu-Gi-Oh!
Find out
it's
next
Digimon.
On Dragon Ball Z! What's another dank anime we can reference? Find out next on Death Note.
Death Note? What? How
it.
Do you hate Death
Whatever.
Note?
Not talking about it.
What?
Ooh, find out next on Evangelion. Okay. The
first,
only proper anime.
You cannot like
<It's fine.
laughs> that over Death Note. It's
so
not
we're
even
sitting
legal.
At even what's really nuts here so far is that we've gotten a whole lot of little taps and goes. Nothing really substantial. Yeah. Neither player has gotten a huge combo in quite yet. I think this speaks to both players really turning it on and being super touch and go and defensive.
Yeah. Definitely a more serious game than the last one. Randall's
Absolutely.
Playing super clean, gets a nice down smash, takes the first stock.
God, I'm so old. My favorite anime is Evangelion.
Yeah, you should do something about that.
Late 90s.
You're only a year older than me.
That's true. You old too.
I look young though, so.
Oh my god, my favorite Animal Crossing character in the background, but it's too late for us to have KK. I just realized that we don't have KK.
No, KK, my boy.
For those of you who are wondering, I love the Museum Archivist Owl.
Lathers.
Yeah, Lathers.
That was a good down.
That was a great down.
Wow. Randall really turning it on in the second set.
Though having the same pose as before. I love looking at posture, guys. And Randall's posture has not changed even an iota since I referred to it
yeah,
last.
Yeah, he's comfortable.
He got it. He's not Mewtwo King-ing, but he's close.
Yeah, Mewtwo King gets too comfortable.
We got the side lean for that man. Wow, that might. Oh, why did I think? I missed the percentage in my head. I'm gonna kill. If Mega Man were at 140, that would have killed. But that's another day.
Up throw?
That will kill. Wow. Okay. I'm not gonna pick that anymore because obviously I'm an idiot.
Oh, down tilt will do it though. See, that's how you predict, Josh.
Yeah, by seeing how this binky hype. This is the fourth binky we've either. Gotten to point out so far in these two sets.
Oh, trips, no follow-up. Well, get to follow-up, actually.
First.
I guess I can't predict.
Despite most trips stopping working at certain percentages, Kirby's down tilt trips at a surprisingly late. Most trips stopped working around 70, 75. The down tilt worked until, I think that was at 80 that it kept working. His down tilt has a really high rate of trip at all percentages. Look at this. Look at this. You're going to duck under anything. I'm just going to deal with everything.
Yeah. This is like crazy, like the way these two players are like spacing right now.
What's great, though, is we saw Swag adapting on the fly. Oh, you're going to duck? I'm just going to down tilt. Sorry about it.
He thought you had answers?
Mm-hmm. It's a whole different SAT.
Oh, nice grab. I always love it when Kirby's get down or the grab.
Oh,
Again,
my God.
He gets this read on that all the time.
Shout out to Florence and the Machine.
Randall was telling me earlier that he likes using that up smash on Mega Man because he can crouch.
Yeah.
He can crouch his pellets and then up smash and it brings him back
it
to melee.
So
melee Falco double lasers.
Ah, there you go. Oh my gosh, what a gorgeous up smash. That doesn't even like I'm still reeling from how perfect of a read
that
was. Oh, I really want the second hit of I lied to you earlier on stream, by the way, chat. The strongest move with knockback growth in Kirby's arsenal is the second hit of up B. The flaccid affair is a close second, but the knockback growth king move for Kirby is the second hit of up B, which is why it spikes so intensely, especially as percentage goes up.
All right.
But still, fair is a close second. Wow, Riz is really risky recovery from triple R.
Randall using all of his
Swag saying, I can get you. No.
Try to snipe him. Aimbot was off today.
Well, it's been off for quite a bit for a while today.
It was on against Pow Pow.
That's true. Shout out to Pow Pow for getting aimbotted.
It happens to the best of us.
Nope. I am the aimbot.
Ooh. He would have got him with that fourth smash.
He absolutely would have. Wow. Flame sword.
Here we go. Last stock.
Wow. It was a really cute momentum shifting down the universe. You going this way? No, I'm going to go that way. I have a leaf shield. Sorry about it. I love that kind of stuff. All about those movement options.
Yeah.
the thing that early in this game there was a lot of complaints that the movement options were really limited, but we've taken beer versing and momentum shifting to a whole new level in this game so far. Not Brawl levels, because that was crazy.
Brawl was fun.
Lucas's side B and Brawl was a ridiculous, just a ridiculous series.
Yeah, that was all over the place.
Ooh, the run after. I love it when both these players are the kind that don't want to roll. They don't want to get to a roll, so they dash.
Run away.
And there's just a quick moment where Kirby is chasing Mega Man, and you can just imagine, you can just hit it like he's running away from the goddamn.
Yeah,
ooh,
down.
Wow!
Randall takes game one.
Very, very, very astutely predicting that Swag was going to try and spot dodge or somehow defend against what might have been a grab, but no, just going right in for the forward smash.
Yep, Randall usually using a down smash in that situation.
That's true. Or re-grabbing, or you know, any sort of options. The down air has a whole lot of tricksy options, of course. All right. Oop, wrong one again. This is what you do when you backseat drive, folks. You click the wrong seam and you transition to the left.
It's all good.
You're sitting about 10 feet away from the computer. 5 feet away from the computer.
We got reached, though. No.
Right. Wireless mice for the win. Battlefield again. Still.
Who won here last time? Was it Swag? No Rush? I thought Rush was going to save
it. Yeah, no, I was waiting for Rush there. It's so odd. I think there might be a worry. Wow.
Yeah.
The shuriken wasn't even make sense there. It deals a significant amount of damage, but it doesn't put you in pits time
long.
Maybe
it's the just condition. I'm like, you can't really run up on me.
It could. Wow. Randall going super deep. Ooh.
Yeah.
I don't really understand the point of it. Why did he go that deep? All right. Regardless.
Regardless of the choices he may have made.
Yeah, or not.
He didn't get punished so hard.
That's
so
true.
As long as you don't get punished, it's fine.
Wow. Another up smash. Triple R doing the same sort of thing that ended that last stock.
Yep.
Trying to get Swag to fear the up smash. I predict that very soon we're going to start seeing some re-grabs. Some down air grab, rather. Just as Swag starts sitting in shield. You heard it here first, folks. Wow!
In an up smash
The Prince Kirby read. Prince Kirby, I hope you're watching at home. I hope someone can text Prince Kirby and say, Randall is hopping your style on the stream right now.
He
should
all
use the default
notes.
Color. What are we doing here?
Randall, change colors, please. You're
Admit
no
it.
Longer Randall.
Reveal your... Take that mask off.
So PK's
we
doing pretty well
left.
Against Swag, but...
Wow. Oh, my gosh. Rush almost forcing a kill.
Yes.
The first time Rush killed someone. Wow.
Ooh, neutral B to shuriken.
Well, we saw that before in the customs meta. But it's nice to see it still functions with regular Metal Blade.
Oh, yeah. Wait, didn't they use regular Metal Blade?
He did. He has before. No, he would always. Oh yeah, he did regular Metal Blade. That's right. I'm thinking of side B.
Yeah.
The little bloop thing that also conditioned a good spot for.
Yeah.
Ooh. Every time he goes to that spike, I have a moment on my insides. I cringe.
Yeah, it's like oh.
Oh my gosh.
Randall gets a trump, but doesn't go for the back air.
Oh my gosh. He's ducking.
Down tilt straight.
The hallmark of Randall's play, Triple R's play in Melee, is the ducking. Famously ducking under Mewtwo King's grab as Sheik. And now ducking under, famously, Swag's pellets. Second set of grand finals, the UMN December monthly.
These up airs are keeping him in the air, and he comes drilling down.
Wow.
Just the re-grab.
A phenomenal pivot grab, too. Wow, I feel like a salesperson. Wow, it's clean. Pat passed. Back throw killing.
Billy Mays.
Wow. Back throw killing. I know.
That
I know
fast.
I know Kirby's super light, but like. Whoa.
Yeah, that was a little early. I wonder if he was DI'ing.
It might have been a DI mix up, but I don't. Somehow I don't think so.
Yeah,
I
would expect a back throw in that situation.
That's true.
I think that was a back air.
That was a good trade there. Oh!
No.
I want it so bad. Both of these players clearly showing why they're in grand finals, clearly showing why they deserve the prize at the end of the night for first place. But still, what a lengthy journey we still get to go. One of them has to win at least twice more.
What is first prize tonight?
360. Wow!
Forward smash. Oh my god, I could buy Xenoblade with that. I could buy Wii U and Xenoblade.
You could buy a lot more than Xenoblade. You could probably buy a Skell. ooh, Xenoblade references. Hey girl, hey. I've watched Felton play that. You can watch that on my stream as well. But knockback growth, not base knockback. Very relevant there.
Yep.
10% is not enough to trigger a lot of base of knockback growth.
Whoa, read the rule.
How did
I remember
a
monthly ago or two?
Yes.
Swag was saying, I can't let Randall get away with these rolls, and he definitely didn't let him get away with that one.
There is. Randall may look like butter, but he is not having these rolls today.
No. The classic.
Oh, it was so cute. Gotta steal from the great sometime.
Oh, will we see follow-ups? Oh, he just grabs the Metal Blade and throws it up. This game, Randall brought it back. It was looking...
Absolutely.
At the start of the stock, it was looking a little grim.
Mm-hmm.
Now it's fairly even. Even though Mega Man is heavy and Kirby is late.
It's, I mean... With the caliber of reads that Triple R's been getting.
Yes.
Like right here, potential for a grab. See, the grab. Okay, I'm not going to say I was right, but I'm going to say I was wrong. Whoa! Domo, get out of my head. get out of Randall's head. Oh, my gosh.
But Swag, I mean, it does cover a lot of options.
It does. Absolutely does. No, it's a phenomenal option. It's just so...
Especially against Swag. Like, he's been... Either, like, jumps and air dodges to get back on, that's going to be
that's
it.
Oh, back throw is going to do it. No.
What? That kill? It must have been DI earlier. I'm calling DI earlier then.
You're calling DI shenanigans.
Yep.
I hear that.
Up throw?
Up throw might do it. Oh, or not. Or just let him hit the ledge again. It's cool.
All right.
Ooh, okay.
A little greedy.
He was hoping not that he wouldn't snap the ledge.
Yeah.
He's been doing consistently, though, so I don't know why he's going to do it. Back throw, not going to do it. But again, this
big.
Is sketchy because this is a really good situation for Swag because Triple R might be DI-ing in different ways to prepare for an up throw at this point. Whoa!
Yeah, but he hasn't really gone for up throw.
That hasn't hit yet, but every time it goes, it's so scary. The All first right. hit of Nair.
Every hit send Kirby, like, across the stage.
Oh!
He lived!
We live in.
That's
oh!
it.
Oh, God.
That's it.
I cannot right. cope with the shenanigans on the screen right now. I am freaking out.
Very nice by Dad.
I am freaking out with the
Best
shenanigans on the screen right now.
No.
What?
In my opinion.
What is this Grand Finals match?
It's
what is this?
Oh, Randall.
What is this Grand Finals match?
He's like, all right. He's feeling himself. He's like, all right, let me stretch a little bit.
I don't know if he's feeling himself.
I don't know.
I think his
like,
neck hurts.
Yeah.
I don't mind my neck would hurt from craning back from all the surprises going on there.
Yeah. Just jumping around. Oh, I didn't
God.
Get hit by that.
Oh, God.
What are we doing? I was looking at the camera at ourselves.
It is what it is. You can Giphy that cat stream. You're welcome. This is Josh and Down for the Cause making dinosaur poses for your entertainment.
Where's the Yoshi?
Where's the Yoshi at? Last Yoshi, I think, got 13th. Sorry about it.
Who was it, Chiki?
Yes. So, no, Cheeky didn't do singles. So, what did King Ben get today?
King
Ben made 32.
Yeah.
I do want to talk for half a second about how every one of the top four is a solo main character, solo main player. You know, Pow Pow was Sonic, Shinjobi was Greninja.
No,
talk about Roy. But Swag, of course, Mega Man, and Triple R was the perennial Kirby. Been around since 2004?
I have no idea.
I think 2004. I'll ask him over dinner. Ooh, it sounds so classy. Mm-hmm. I'll ask him over dinner. Oh. Hey, girl, hey. Triple R is big, and that's okay.
Ooh. Josh enjoying his commentary.
I'm just mesmerized at the screen, mesmerized at the way that the Swag is interlacing these hellish barrages with these hyper-offensive options, really throwing off the rhythm of the match.
That was really smart. Oh,
it was really risky.
Randall the DI that trump down.
Let's fastfall like a lunatic. That sounds like a great idea.
Hey.
We ain't Sonic. I guess we're Sonic.
Oh.
Wow.
Is that? No. Mega Man's a... He's
if
got
I
all that
If I say Shoryuken one more time, it'll be too soon, but maybe you should stop going for it. Swag, maybe you should stop going for the Shoryukens. Maybe this is not the optimal way to punish Triple R existing.
He wants that roll punish. He wants to tell him, dude, don't roll in on me.
This is just insane.
I'm not the one.
I'm not the one. not the Prince Kirby one, that's true.
Yeah.
Prince Kirby and Ganon Beast early today winning doubles. The brother pair. The ones.
The ones.
Taking home.
Knocking First everyone out. Up.
Really confusing leaf shield. Down throw,
cancel,
not going to do it. Okay, down throw also a move with a high level of knockback growth, but not a lot of base and just not generally strong. I mean, I suppose it's better than up throw if he's not near a platform.
I was going to say, if he gets the up throw in the center.
That center, oh yeah, it's done. It's Dunzo. It's Dunzo McGee. Ooh, little tiny footstool, little adorable tap on the head. Oh,
beautiful back air. Randall's so good at that.
He is. We haven't seen a whole lot of it. We haven't seen a whole lot of bear out of shield. That wasn't a bear out of shield necessarily,
yeah,
but we haven't seen a whole lot of bear out of shield from Triple R, which is his one of his sort of standard plays.
Yeah, that's if how he gets a lot of his stocks.
Absolutely. If you were to write up a Triple R playbook, it would be like number four.
At least.
Bear out of shield. Trump bear.
And if you're talking about melee, it's like...
Oh, you're right.
It's super... It'd be even like lower, probably like...
Oh! Swag getting really, really thirsty for this kill. Kirby's so light. This is he's practically a tennis ball at this point. Wow.
Double back air.
Wow, these are cute. These are cute little strings.
Just hitting them with the tips. Is that Mark?
That's going to be it. Wow. Okay.
Battlefield paying off.
Stream, every time I do that, electroshock me. Thanks. Oh, up air.
Yeah, he jumped.
Once again.
You can't. You just got to air dodge and pray.
Despite Swag saying on Twitter at some point that you can DI down on those things and live forever, I'm calling shenanigans. I'm calling him a liar. Something tells me. Okay?
Unless you're Kirby.
Shinjobi over to my right suggests that probably not if you're floating like Kirby. I'm still... Wow. He ducked under the uncharged
Kirby
forward
smash.
Oh my God. Pancaking to victory. The triple R story. New Twitter bio. At triple underscore Randall.
There was once
pancaking to victory.
There was once a Kirby.
There was. If you give a Kirby a pancake...
He'll go far in life.
He'll go far. You teach him Kirby to pancake. If, whatever.
He'll crouch a forward smash. Dad, our swag, not letting Randall come back. And up airs the up B.
Oh my god. A really wise rock, but
no
he doesn't
jumps.
Even jumps. I thought he was going to die at the top. Why'd he die off the bottom? Nothing makes sense.
Oh, Randall.
Down for the cause of what just happened.
Randall
the rock was gorgeous.
Get in
gorgeous.
The beast today.
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh.
He had no hops. I can't believe it. Randall's like so well at like...
I mean, so let's be fair here. Kirby has mediocre vertical recovery. Compared to other characters in this game, other characters on this game,
that's
Kirby
confirmed.
Has mediocre vertical recovery.
Yeah.
Five jumps, that's fine. They go like... Well, bloop, bloop. They don't go very far up though, off the ground.
Yeah,
Sonic, Mega Man, shoots 20 stories into the air.
Yeah.
Hitting up B. Marth, not great recovery either. Kirby's better. But think about that. Think of how often Marth gets gimped.
Like never, because of B so good.
One of Kirby's big weaknesses is great horizontal mobility, mediocre vertical. Again, Randall, stop it. Don't get hit by the tornadoes. Oh my god.
All right.
This is a
He's
huge game
out of jumps,
three.
Though.
This is a huge game three.
Yeah, whoever wins this is definitely going to have... He's going to be sitting pretty in the next at least two games. Or at most two games.
I can empathize with Triple R here. As a character, as someone who plays a character that has a lot of, in my case, upbeat fuel, but in this case, jumps, it's really easy to forget when they start. Oh my god!
Beautiful punish.
This doesn't make sense, stream. This doesn't make
Dad's
sense.
Dad's not trying to get excited yet. He's smiling, though. Give
it
that.
We see it.
I
mean, it's an uncomfortable smile. He knows
that.
There's still
three
more stocks that separate him from winning, and he has to take them consecutively. He can't take three stocks collectively. We're not doing an Iron Man, which was great for earlier today.
Ganon the Beast.
That was a great
pow.
Great moment of the day.
I loved commentating that.
I bet that was wonderful. I mean, it was wonderful to watch.
Yeah. I was like, you guys don't know about getting the Beast, Captain Falcon.
We're cleaning the glasses. This is not an anime move, but we're cleaning the glasses.
Uh-oh.
We're being practical.
We're getting serious now. Randall has the glasses off, guys.
Oh, God, yeah. No.
Glasses are
we have
off.
I just noticed we have a glasses grand finals.
FD?
Smashville. They went right to Smashville. I think I'm right. Smashville is one of those. I mean, ultimately, at this point, Gentleman's applies really strongly. If Swag says, Smashville's fine, then they go to Smashville.
Lilat
again.
Boo.
We saw it set one.
But good choice for Randall.
Yeah, of course. Who knows?
Did he win here last time? I think he lost. Oh, Dad's like, you can't roll in on me.
Here's a tip to everyone who wants to be a commentator in the future. If you're going to have to deal with a grand final set, bring a piece of paper and write this stuff down.
Right, what?
I should have a chart that says game one, they went here, here's who won. I just don't, and I have no idea.
You're right. That would be very
We've seen eight phenomenal games. I don't remember what they're from them. I can tell you what stages they're on. We haven't seen Town and City yet.
Yep. No one likes it there.
In this grand final set.
Yeah.
Haven't seen Duck Hunt? No, we saw
Tree
Duck Hunt.
Grabs, forward throw, down throw, must be better.
Down throw for damage and positioning. don't forget that, especially before Kirby can kill, it's important for Kirby to exert stage control to get the beats.
Yes.
Ooh.
Ooh, nice air dodge the back air.
There's definitely something to be said about studying these two character players and how they assert their stage control. When Swag has stage control like this, it's all walling pressure. Don't, how dare you come back down. Eat these thousand projectiles. When Kirby has stage pressure, it's things like this. How do you avoid my traps?
Down air confirms are the best.
This is satisfying. And it's nice that Kirby finally has something like this after, wow!
Oh after you told him
can
to stop, he didn't listen.
Binky
hyped.
17 and a half Shoryuken kills. And we tell him every time to stop going for them, but he's gotten so many hits.
Who cares if you miss three, if you land five?
Minty Guy, looking at this chat really quickly, yes, I will upload the Iron Man. The Iron Man and the Greninja Dittos, a.k.a. Shinjobi slaughtering.
Oh my god, 10-0.
We'll all be up on YouTube. Everything from today will be up on YouTube.
God, I was like, how do you not lose a stock in a bet? Or do a first of five?
Down air into up tilt. Felt like Fox for 2 seconds. Fox, the almost perfect character, according to my control host to my right.
Oh yeah, you know.
DDD is the perfect character according to a game screen.
It's actually Fox. They're wrong.
Wow, even more
tornado. I just gotta get better.
At this point, I'm terrified for triple R for the tornadoes.
Yeah, because they kill him. Like,
I'm so nervous.
One small mistake inside the tornado, he's dead.
Swag sitting pretty, sitting even with triple R, which for him is an advantage because he has a whole other game
to burn.
Yeah,
he has a whole game.
Which isn't a whole lot after doing 10 of 8 of them, but this might be it. Don't forget, guys, this may be the first time Swag wins a UMN or at any Minnesota tournament. Wow, whoa. Forward smash! Gotta
and
get it!
And it does it! Randall.
Right, Randall fighting that to
was
stay
a
in the tournament.
Show forward smash.
Caruso. Tom Caruso.
Whenever someone gets hit, I always pause on
him. So all Randall needs to do is get this stock off, and then it's game 5, ooh, set 2 of grand finals, and we draw the line and we say it's time to find out who gets first.
I want to see game 5.
Will Swag prevent it? I want to see a game 5.
Back air. More the Randall bread and butter. Or whatever. Back air out of field.
Oh, okay. I thought you said burn and butter. I was like, you can't burn. I mean, you can burn butter, whatever. You can totally burn butter. Something interesting is, I was talking with Triple R earlier, why doesn't Swag leech shield more? It's interesting because in this matchup, it seems to be just a shutout option. Kirby, wow. Ooh. Kirby can't come in if Swag is protected by Binky Hype. We're going to stop saying that, maybe. Maybe not.
Nah.
We only got 2 more games you guys can do with
Binky Hype. Binky
Hype. Binky Hype.
Let's get some ones.
Press 1 if you enjoy Binky Hype.
Press 2.
Press 2 if you wish we would shut up like Kirby does when he gets hit with that crash bomb.
It's only because it's on his mouth.
Ooh, you're right. I was waiting for sure you can. I'm no word of a lie. I was going to be like, hey, he's going to go for it because it's freaking Swag and this is all he does.
Sure you can.
Sure you can. Fuck days.
Ooh, or down the row.
We're going to get it from this. It's easily kill percentage. Right, do you think?
Yeah.
Expected the back air. Down. Oh!
Not yet.
Oh! Forward smash, wrong direction. No, he gets
ooh,
it.
And he gets it. We got a game 5.
We're going
folks.
To
Let's
game
go.
5. Set 2. Grand
Randall,
finals. At the
taking
the
sip
December
of the water.
Monthly.
Swag waterless. Knocked his glasses off slightly.
Waterless.
He might be a little bit on tilt. Look at him.
Waterless.
He's looking nervous.
they're mapping out the stages. You can see it in their eyes. One on Battlefield did this. I like the gesticulating that Randall is doing. Doing the claws. This is ridiculous. Game 5 here. You probably hear the crowd in the background just getting really excited for a game.
Let's go. Game 5.
Some of them just want to eat. But at the same time, Game 5, it's
game
clear.
Game 5 is always hype. All right. Everyone loves Game 5.
All right. Game 5.
Here we go.
Here it goes.
Moment of truth. Smashville.
Oh my gosh. And the roost. Okay. I'm really excited. Let's kill the roost. In Animal Crossing, it's my favorite thing to get in the 3DS race. I call it Dunkin' Donuts. So we'll see. Who's going to crack?
Up
who's
tilt. Rolling up tilt.
Triple R. No stranger
to,
winning grand finals. Swag. A huge stranger to winning grand finals.
Not a stranger to losing them, though.
Not a stranger to losing. Well, he's been in.
Probably has lost the most.
That's true. And again, we saw this earlier. I looked this up earlier. Their record is now 5-1. Randall winning every set. And a 5-2 because Swag won the last set.
Oh.
So the Triple R has won more sets against Swag. But of course, today we just saw a reset.
Yeah,
we
Swag.
He's
not the same Swag we know and love.
You're right. Every set they've done has gone to game 5.
Randall rolling around. I wonder why.
The speed of sound.
Ooh.
Got no place to go.
All right. Not going to kill.
Shout out Spinner for getting me to learn the lyrics to that God Forsaken song.
It's all about live and learn.
Reach
no
the
one
stars
likes
is emotional.
Living.
Oh, like wow, that was such an opportunity there for some any sort of follow up.
But
nope.
I think Randall was trying to see how he would react.
You gotta mix people up.
Yep. Because he.
Oh! Oh my gosh, he had no job.
He's like, we bat those, nah.
If only had a reflector. That'd be ridiculous.
That would. That'd change the game.
Oh my gosh.
Not really, but it would. I love Swag's pivot forward smashes. They're just so clean.
Oh my gosh.
Oh.
Ooh, a little tap with the side. Wow! Literally almost leading everything to a side.
Here we go.
To a
here we go.
Air.
Nothing. Sorry, guys. Getting you all.
The spacing so far has just been phenomenal. Both players knowing what the other's options are and trying just their damnedest to help them avoid it. While throwing their offense options, it will kill. Yes, it will. Good call. Look at you. It's like you play the game or something.
Yeah, you
boss.
Know.
Look
you know.
You.
It would have killed me in Kirby's lighter, so.
Killing it.
So.
Good back throw.
Down
oh,
air.
Oh, down air is nothing quite.
Ooh,
back
nice
air. Back air hit.
Yep.
We need hitbox data in this game, guys. Why did back air hit there? How wide is back air's range of influence?
The coding guys don't love us, so.
I'm gonna say anti-shout-out to Minty Guy for doing a terrible interpretation of Walk Up Slowly. And come on, guy. It's old. That meme is dead. It was dead for 6 years and suddenly revived it. We don't need this in our lives.
Oh,
slowly.
If he would have got the grab, he would have up through platform game. Well, not game, but.
Living. I think this is the longest Swag's lived in any of their games so far today.
That late?
That.
Ooh. Rage. Ooh. I'm guessing up air doesn't have that much knockback growth.
No, it certainly doesn't.
Oh, that might.
Wow. Someone screaming, get the balloon in the background.
In grand finals.
This is insane. Swag just living to extreme percentages. This is what may turn it in Swag's favor.
This is game
Kirby
five, guys.
Needs to end the stock now, and I know it's a
cliche. Oh my god, Kirby's so late.
Rage is becoming such a huge
problem. Oh, that's
wow!
It.
It's three stocks. God! We got Mega Man 189%. Triple R needing to close the stock now. Up throw. There we go. Fine. Right. Done.
No!
Whoa! Excuse me? This is it. That was the ticket to Swag winning. 207%. This is a Sisyphean task at this
Where's
point.
The
that's how uphill it is, guys. It's Sisyphean for Triple R. We're getting literary up in here.
Yeah, you are.
Okay, nailed it.
All right,
back here.
Bread and butter.
Give
Randall butter.
A breath. Give him a breath. Give him any hope.
All right, here we go. It all starts with one, guys. Randall made bigger comebacks.
He has. Absolutely, he has. But will we see one today? It's been a long
here we
day.
Go.
Look at his slump. Look at the way he's sitting. Stare at it.
We people. Believe in you, Randall.
I kind of want Swag to win. We can be both. So one of us can be good cop, bad cop. We're not going to say who's who.
I'm.
Oh, my gosh. I'm just so nervous for Randall, for Triple R. Any stray hit will just give. The more damage he tacks on, the harder this is going to be.
Oh, I thought he was going to up tilt, but.
I mean, at this point, it's an unsafe option. You have to be super safe now.
Yep.
Triple R can't,
yeah, he can't take
throw
damage.
Himself around anymore.
And these pellets slowly racking up damage.
We're not over here about pellets. That would be about shurikens or about bears and bigger hits. Pellets are fine.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, they'll start adding up.
That's fine. But again, here we go. An offstage situation.
Here
can
we go.
Triple R.
Floating a little too high.
Ooh, we almost had a Domo read, but it was wise to go for the grab. Maybe he was expecting the Domo read.
Yeah.
Domo read. The Prince Kirby read. Whatever.
The
oh my
Domo
gosh.
Read. Now he has to start worrying about Shuri.
And I can see the frustration on Triple R's face with the pellets. Oh, God!
That's it.
Oh, that's it! It's over!
Called the Shuriken. He has to watch it.
Wow.
And then he gets hit by it.
Triple R.
Oh, he's mad. Oh, well.
Oh, my gosh.
Good game to
and
both of
And the salt
them.
Overfloweth. And I feel for Triple R, and I feel for him really badly. He took a long journey today. Got a stock reset, or got a set reset.
Swag finally wins his first tournament.
Swag taking... This first Minnesota tournament, finally putting everyone who said, well, he's number one, but that's cute, but whatever.
But he doesn't win.
To
but
shame. Because
congrats
that,
to you.
72 people here today, Swag taking number one, beating out enormous numbers of competition, doing phenomenal work, coming back into from losers, resetting it, doing just shy of 106 games in a row, relevantly. All right.
I'm just saying the first thing he did was get water, and I mentioned that.